the ordination looks like a certain alleluia. Dopo il suo disco, inizia il San Evangelista del
quadro.
In principio era ebro ed era Adonai, e Deo sarebbe. Hoc era il principio Adonai. Omnia ipsa fatus, in sine ipsa fatus in quel fatus. Inizio vita erat, et vita erat and looks at tenebrae speech and tenebrae in the matter of men. For it on the misses of them, cui non eleguos. Even in the testimony, or testimony of the very illuminate, were almost clear in the way. And yet in the very books, said testimony of the very illuminate, and it looks very quiet, illuminate on the omnia of the other mundo. And mundo erat, and mundus per ipsum facusus, mundus neum naturat, et propria vent et sui neum nature erat, corpus altera genera eum, et in eis modestatus filios dei filis, is qui credit in omni eus, qui non est sacrificus, neque est voluntati caros, neque est voluntati vi, sed et ex Deo natus, et verbum caro factum est, in altari vivimus, et vivimus gloria Gloria quasi genitia padre, clam grazie et veritatis. The epistle for this third Mass of Christmas is taken from St. Paul's letter to Hebrews, chapter 1, verses 1 to 12. God, who at sundry times and in divers manners spoke in times past to the fathers by the prophets, last of all, in these days, hath spoken to us by the Son, who he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the world, who being the brightness of his glory, and the figure of his substance, and upholding all things by the word of his power, making purgation of sins, sitteth at the right hand of majesty on high, being made so much better than the angels, as he hath inherited a more excellent name. For to which of the angels hath he said in his time, Thou art my son, today have I begotten thee, and again I will be to him a father, and he shall be to me a son? And again, when he bringeth the first begotten into the world, he said, Let all the angels of God adore him. And to the angels of me, he said, He that maketh his angels spirits, and his ministers a flame of fire. But to the Son, thy throne, O God, is forever, and ever a scepter of justice is the scepter of thy kingdom. Thou hast loved justice, and hath hated iniquity. Therefore God, thy God, hath appointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellows. And thou in the beginning, O Lord, this founding earth, and the works of thy hands are the heavens. They shall perish, but thou shalt continue, and they shall all grow old as a garment. And as a vestment they shall be changed. But thou art thyself saying, and thy ears shall not fall. The Holy God, the beginning of the Holy Gospel, according to John, chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him. Without Him was made nothing that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of all men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. This man came for witness to give testimony of the light, that all men might believe through him. He was not the light, but was to give testimony of the light. That was the true light, which enlightened every man that cometh into this world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, he gave the power to be made the sons of God to them that believe in his name, who are born not of blood, not of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Now we saw in his glory, the glory as it were of the only begotten the Father, full of grace and truth. Merry Christmas, Buon Natale, Feliz Navidad, wish you well to each and every one here with the privilege that we have of celebrating the true Mass, which we speak about many times, is an unbroken 2,000-year heritage. Now, somebody said to me about technology. Well, the same with technology. So technology, let's just say because of medical science, gets better and better. You don't remove the essence, but it gets better and better. This Mass and the Church of the Mob over nowadays, for that almost 2,000 years, I figure about the year 30 when Jesus will us found the Church. The Church that the liturgy evolved, we have our true Mass. Unbroken tradition, and even time has unbroken it. Some have come along, broken it, tried to. They will not succeed. Anyway, this Holy Mass is the third Mass of Christmas Day, on which we will not be reading the last Gospel, because Reverend is with two intentions. One is a thanksgiving to Our Lady of Carmel, request that Marsha Alborg, and let's, for a special attention for our dear friend here, Father John Albert, who has been celebrating Mass for many years. He's with us, but who has good health and all things, and a couple little difficulties, so I think you should have a nice offer for you for these intentions. And just a little nostalgia to give to you during the Mass. I believe it was 1989. And in 1989, the second Mass with Father Frank. And at the end of the Mass, the baby Jesus was in the sky. Now, I know as a little girl, when we were talking about the baby Jesus was, and how Father Frank had a little grumpy at times. He went home after the Mass, Christmas Day, we're going to say Mass, went to his family. And after that, I went home, I was home that night in Jersey. They used to come in by car, so come here on Sunday, I think people do. And I found out that he was driving back home long story short, he went to Mr. Recording Master of the Bronx, had quadruple bypass, five bypasses. And after the bypass surgery, at about, let's say, maybe 1 or 2 Sundays after Easter, he was much better. And he was very small, very vibrant with mass, and so on. So just a thought that this one to share with you while I had the mass. And then we can remember Father Frano with the mass as well. He started the mass in January of 1989 before St. Agnes. And we're continuing in the help of God. We're going to do it. I don't care. Well, I don't care who is the Holy Father, but this is the mass. You're too bad for all. Anyway. Et verbum cum factum is, in adicati dinomis. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. What we call Blessed Gospel, which is read in the Mass, is known as the prologue to the Gospel according to St. John. Prologos in Greek, meaning the first words. He gives you an outline of what St. John is presenting to us. The light, the word, the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And the light shone in the darkness, but the darkness couldn't overcome. Which is telling us that Jesus came unto his own and they refused to recognize him. Because he was so bottled up with pride, egoism, that it blinded naturally by the darkness. That no matter what, and we know in the gospel, whether it's the gospel according to St. John or the evangelist, that no matter what Jesus said and did, no matter what miracles he performed to bring the light into the world, the darkness refused to be overcome by the light. So much so that the darkness couldn't imagine, couldn't conceive that Jesus Christ, the Messiah, who came into the world as he did. He came in born, he came in as a cute little baby, and he comes to us not in ways that we expect him to come. If it's up to us to expect him to come to us or others, we'll probably, like those in the darkness, we'll refuse to accept him. He comes in the most impoverished and unimagined ways possible. Who could have imagined back then, even though the prophets first called him, the prophets Isaiah, Jeremiah the son of Sam, and all the others, but Isaiah specifically prophesies the root of Jesse would come, but then he becomes a cute little baby. He was expected to come in royalty, to be born in a royal palace that probably conceived by his, that being brought into the world by the nurse, lady nurse, and then he would be brought to his father who was seated on the throne. This is your successor, this is the Messiah. That's more or less how he conceived the Messiah was to be born. And to this day, that is why amongst the Jewish people, Messiah still has not come yet. And that's why the gospel we read, that it's not by blood, not by will, but by God is born to us this faith that we can accept and receive Jesus. He came so that we could accept him. And he came in such a warm, kind, gentle way. So human beings could embrace him, hug him, love him. But that wasn't enough. Because as you see over here, we go from the crib to the cross. But that wasn't enough. But then he had to manifest to the extent that he wanted us to come to what love was all about. Infinite love. So from that little baby to giving his life for the salvation of the world. All so you and I could have life, have the light, live it to the full, and at last be free. But as long as the world refuses to be overcome by the light, the world will be stuck and seated in the slavery of its own sin. As we say in the world, they'll choke in their own vomit. But for us, every day we must accept him and receive him more and more and welcome him into our hearts. And the more that we do so, the more freer, happier we become, and the more we wish to share our joy, our light, and peace with others. Just a quick thing that Father Barry was mentioning last night. Father Barry used the word joy. Jesus did the three priorities of our lives. First is Jesus, others being concerned for others, and then you, meaning me. Jesus, others, then myself. Joy. That's what Jesus is all about. God bless you. Merry Christmas. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Grazie a tutti.